Good morning, children. This is class 10th, subject mathematics, chapter number 2, polynomials, lecture number 1. Children, before I start explaining you about polynomials, let us quickly recall the concept of algebraic expression. What do you mean by algebraic expression? Algebraic expression is that expression in which variables and constants are connected to each other with different mathematical operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Here, this is one example I have given of algebraic expression, that is 2x plus 7. Fine. Now, we are going to switch to polynomials. Polynomial is an algebraic expression in which the variable which is present in that polynomial, the degree of that variable must be a whole number, means it must be a positive integer. So let us start. Polynomial is an algebraic expression of the form px is equal to a n n x raised to the power n plus a n minus 1 x raised to the power n minus 1 up to a 2 x square plus a 1 x plus a naught. Here, children, you can see that this is a polynomial in x. What is the highest power of the variable present in it? That is n. You have to see all the powers, n, n minus 1, 2, here x raised to the power 1, and here x raised to the power naught is also present. So they all should be whole numbers. So what can we say, where n is a positive integer and a naught, a 1 up to a n, they all are the coefficients of the variable present in the polynomial. Let us switch to the types of polynomial. Number 1, linear polynomial. Linear polynomial, as it is clear from the name itself, linear polynomial is that polynomial in which the power of the variable present in that polynomial is 1. Here you can see through this example, this is 2x plus 3. This is a polynomial in variable x, and what is the highest power of the variable present in it? That is 1. So such kind of expressions are known as linear polynomials. Next is quadratic polynomial. Clear again from the name itself. Quadratic polynomial is that polynomial in which the degree of the variable present in that polynomial must be 2. So this is the example, that is 2x square plus 9x plus 7. Here, children, you can see that what is the highest power of the variable present in it? That is 2. Now, we are going to switch to cubic polynomial. Cubic polynomial, cubic means 3. So the variable which is present in the polynomial, the highest power of that variable must be 3. So the example is x cube plus 2x square plus 9x plus 7. Now next is biquadratic polynomial. Biquadratic means the highest power will be 4. Here you can see the example, x raised to the power 4 plus 9x cube plus 7x square plus 9x plus 11. So this is a biquadratic polynomial. Children, you can write as many polynomials as you want. Next is graphical representation of the polynomial. Number 1, for linear polynomial, always remember, children, that the graph of a linear polynomial will be a straight line. Here I have drawn a straight line on the Cartesian plane. This is x-axis, this is y-axis, and this is the graph of a linear polynomial. Now, wherever the graph of the linear polynomial is going to intersect x-axis, that many zeros will be possible of a linear polynomial. Children, you know very well what are the zeros of the polynomial. Basically, they are the solution of that polynomial. Correct? So, here it is going to be intersect x-axis at one point. So, definitely the number of zeros will be 1. Let us switch to next polynomial, that is quadratic polynomial. This is the generalized form of a quadratic polynomial, that is ax square plus bx plus c. And the graph of the quadratic polynomial will be a parabola. Either it will be open from upward or it will be open from the downward. Now that depends. If this a, which is the numerical coefficient of x square, is greater than 0, means a positive value, then definitely upward parabola will be formed. But if a is less than 0, then downward parabola will be formed. Children, here you can see that it is going to be intersect. This graph, the parabola, is going to be intersect x-axis at two points. So, how many zeros does it have? Definitely, the quadratic polynomial will be having two zeros. Understood? Now, on the basis of this, I am going to take the questions from exercise 2.1. You will be having the graphs given. The graph of the polynomial in x are drawn below. You have to just let me know how many zeros does the polynomial have. See children, in this graph, you can see that this is the graph of a straight line. So, means it will be a linear polynomial. But this linear polynomial is not going to intersect x-axis at any of the point. So, the zeros of this polynomial will be 0 only. So, here zeros of polynomial in x will be 0 because the graph of px does not intersect x-axis at any point. Now, I have taken one more question based on the same concept. Here you can see that this is a graph of a parabola, means we are dealing with the quadratic polynomial. So, here it is going to be intersect x-axis at 2 points. So, definitely how many zeros does it have? 2. Here the zeros of the polynomial in x is 2 because the graph of px intersect x-axis at 2 points. Children, before I start switching to exercise 2.2, once quickly recall the concept, the relationship between the zeros and the coefficient of a quadratic polynomial. This is px. This is a generalized form of a quadratic polynomial, that is ax square plus bx plus c. Here a and b are the numerical coefficient of x square and x, and c is the constant value. You have just come to know that for a quadratic polynomial, there will be two zeros existence, right? So, let alpha and beta be the zeros of the polynomial in x. This is the generalized form I have written. When you know very well that when alpha and beta are the zeros of px, so what can we say? That x minus alpha and x minus beta will be the factor of the same polynomial. So, here if I am going to multiply x minus alpha by x minus beta and inserting some constant over here, so this complete will again become the quadratic polynomial. Let us multiply. X is multiplied by x, I have got x square. When x is multiplied by minus beta, I have got minus beta x. And when minus alpha is multiplied by x, I have got minus alpha x. From there, I have taken minus as common. So, this is alpha plus beta, and x is also being taken as common. Minus alpha into minus beta has become plus alpha beta. Now, I am going to multiply k with each and every term. This is kx square minus k into alpha plus beta into x plus k alpha beta. Now, this is nothing but again the quadratic polynomial. I am going to compare the coefficient of both the polynomial. Here you can see, when I compare the coefficient of x square of left hand side with the coefficient of x square by right hand side, I have got a is equal to k. Correct? What will be b? B will be minus k with alpha plus beta. What is c? C will be k alpha beta, because this is the constant value. Now, the value of k I am going to insert in expression number 1 and expression number 2. So, through that what I have got, b is equal to, in place of k I am going to put here a with alpha plus beta, and here c, here in place of k I am going to put a alpha beta. So, through this you have come to know that alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, and alpha into beta is equal to c by a. So, what is alpha plus beta? This is nothing but the sum of the zeros, that is minus b by a, and product of the zeros will be c by a. So, now children, I am going to take the questions from exercise 2.2 to make you understand this concept better. So, first question is, let px, which is the polynomial in x, is x square minus 2x minus 8. We have to just calculate the zeros, and after that we have to tell the relation between the zeros and the coefficient. So, you know very well how to solve a quadratic polynomial by factorization method. This is x square minus 2x minus 8 must be equal to 0. Now, I am going to factorize it. Sum should be minus 2 and product should be minus 8. So after factorizing the middle term, I have got x square minus 4x plus 2x minus 8. I am going to take common x from first two term. It will become x into x minus 4 plus 2. I am taking common. This is x minus 4 now. x minus 4 is coming twice. So one time it is written. Another factor is x plus 2. Equating both the expression equal to 0. I have got x is equal to 4 and x is equal to minus 2. These are basically the zeros of this quadratic polynomial. So let first zero be alpha and another zero be beta, because now I am going to just verify the relation between these zeros and the coefficients of this quadratic polynomial. So I have just calculated alpha plus beta, that is 4 plus minus 2 has become 2. Children, can I write this 2 as minus of minus 2 upon 1? This will actually become 2 only. Now, when I compared this quadratic polynomial by its generalized form, that is ax square plus bx plus c, so I have got a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 2 and c is equal to minus 8, correct? So in place of minus 2, what I am going to write? That is b. This minus will come as it is, and in place of 1, I am going to write a. So through this, I have just told the relation of zeros with minus b by a. So sum of the zeros is equal to minus b by a. Let us switch to alpha into beta. That is 4 into minus 2. That is minus 8. What is minus 8 here? C. That is c by a. So through this, children, you have come to know that there is really the relation between the zeros and the coefficient of the polynomial. Now let us switch to the next question. Write a quadratic polynomial when you know the sum, you know the product of the zeros given. Till now we were calculating sum and product. Now we will be having sum and product given. We are just going to form a quadratic polynomial. So sum you know, that is alpha plus beta is equal to 0. Product you know, that is alpha into beta is equal to root 5. So what will be the required quadratic polynomial? That is x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha into beta. X square minus, in place of sum I have written here 0, into x plus root 5. So what is the required quadratic polynomial? That is x square plus root 5. Understood, children? Now what is your maths homework? You have to do exercise 2.1 and 2.2, the remaining parts. Getting? Thank you.